This process is required to make the concentrated filtrate means hypertonic urine. So जब hypertonic urine बनाना होगा, hypertonic urine means जब water का loss नहीं होने देना body से, उस case में ये mechanism काम करती है. So in general, in animals which are living on the land like mammals, including man and birds, etc., which cannot tolerate the loss of water, they adopt this kind of mechanism to prevent the loss of water. पानी का नुकसान ना हो body से, इसके लिए mechanism काम करती है. In our body also, when we are sufficiently hydrated, जब हमने बहुत अच्छे से पानी पिया हुआ है, उस केस में डायलूट यूरिन फॉर्म होगा. बट इफ वी आर नॉट हाइड्रेटेड इनफ दैट द लॉस ऑफ वाटर कैन नॉट बी हैपन टू द बॉडी. सो इन दिस वे दिस मैकेनिज्म विल वर्क. ये मैकेनिज्म काम करती है. तो पहले हम देखेंगे कि काउंटर करंट का क्या मीनिंग है. फिर हम देखते हैं कि वेयर दिस प्रोसेस हैपेंस. काउंटर मींस अपोजिट एंड करंट मींस फ्लो. इफ टू थिंग्स आर मूविंग इनटू द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन, सपोज वन इज मूविंग डाउनवर्ड एंड अनदर इज मूविंग अपवर्ड, एंड दीज टू आर प्रेजेंट नियर टू ईच अदर, वेरी क्लोज टू ईच अदर, सो दिस टाइप ऑफ मूवमेंट इज नॉन एज काउंटर करंट मैकेनिज्म. ओके, अब ये होती कहाँ है? This counter current mechanism is formed in our nephrons. In our kidney, in the nephrons, this mechanism will work. We know we have two types of nephron. One cortical nephron and another one is juxtamedullary nephron. In juxtamedullary nephron, which has long loop of Henle, where this type of mechanism will work because vasorecti will also be there. So, in the juxtamedullary nephrons, jiske andar hum ye dekhe the structure, in the juxtamedullary nephron, this is the structure of nephron we know. They have the long loop of Henle which is situated deeply inside the medulla. Here, this countercurrent mechanism will work because this region is present. This is the cortex region and this one is the medulla region. So, they have long loop of Henle which is situated deeply inside the medulla region. And here, the vasorecti is also present. Yahan pe vasorecti bhi present hoti hai. Vasorecti is the network of capillaries which form around or which make a loop around the loop of Henle. जो loop of Henle के चारों तरफ इस तरीके से loop बनाती है, वो थी vasorecti. हमने ये सब बात की हुई है. So in these kind of nephrons, which are known as juxtamedullary nephron, this countercurrent mechanism will work. Two important part of the nephrons, they take part into this process. These two parts is कहाँ-कहाँ हो रही है इन juxtamedullary nephron में, इस part में हो रही है. This happens into the loop of Henle. It happens in the loop of Henle and second the vasorecti. Vasorecti. So these are the two parts of the nephron where this mechanism works. कैसे होगा? कैसे counter current होता है? पहले हम वो देखें. In the loop of Henle, we know loop of Henle, they have two limbs. यहाँ पे two limbs हैं. One is the descending limb where the filtrate moves downward. Another one is the ascending limb where the filtrate move upward. So एक limb में filtrate नीचे की तरफ जा रहा है, दूसरे में ऊपर की तरफ जा रहा है. And both of these two are present close to each other. Means here, in the loop of Henle, the countercurrent will work. The countercurrent कहाँ काम कर रही है? Loop of Henle के limbs के अंदर. अगर हम वासारेक्टी के रेफरेंस में देखें, सो इन द वासारेक्टी आल्सो दे हैव टू लिम्ब्स, टू लूप्स. इन द वन लूप और वी कैन से दैट इन द वन लूप द ब्लड और द लिक्विड इज मूविंग डाउनवर्ड फ्रॉम कॉर्टेक्स टू मेडुला, एंड इन द अनदर लिम्ब और अनदर लूप द ब्लड इज मूविंग अपवर्ड फ्रॉम मेडुला टू कॉर्टेक्स. सो लूप ऑफ हेनले में भी अपोजिट फ्लो हो गया मूवमेंट का, और वासारेक्टी में भी हो गया. सो दीस टू दे आर कंबाइंड इन मेकिंग और दे आर टेकिंग पार्ट टू मेंटेन दिस काउंटर करंट मैकेनिज्म. Here, the salts which are taking part, अब counter current mechanism काम करता है ताकि पानी को बाहर निकाला जा सके filtrate से और urine concentrated बन सके. Water तो बाहर तभी आएगा जब बाहर का environment hypertonic होगा, and this hypertonic environment is maintained by the some solutes. The solute which are taking part into this process is sodium chloride and urea. These are the two important solutes. ये सबसे important चीजें हैं जो बताई जा रही हैं. ये दोनों solutes आपको पता होने चाहिए, where this mechanism works ये आपको मालूम होने चाहिए. So sodium chloride and the urea, these are the two solutes which work here or which take part in maintaining this countercurrent mechanism. अब ये कैसे होगा? इसे हम detail में करते हैं. We will make the separate diagram or we can say that superimposed diagram of this loop of Henle and vasorecti. Because vasorecti is running parallel to loop of Henle. तो हम इसका डायग्राम एक दूसरे तरीके से बना के इसे समझने की कोशिश करते हैं. The complete process. What we are doing now? Let's see. This is the loop of Henle. This is our loop of Henle. It's a loop of Henle and it's the descending limb of the loop of Henle and this one is the ascending limb. And when we draw the vasa recti, agar hum vasa recti ki baat kare, which is running parallel to the loop of Henle, it also has the two loops. Iske bhi two loops hai. NCRT में इस तरीके के इस डायग्राम को इसके साइड में बना के दिखाया हुआ वासा रेक्टी को, बट यू कैन मेक दिस काइंड आल्सो. दिस इज द वासा रेक्टी इन व्हिच द ब्लड इज मूविंग डाउनवर्ड इन दिस लूप, वेयर द ब्लड इज मूविंग अपवर्ड इन दिस लूप. ओके, सो दिस इज द लूप ऑफ Henle. अराउंड द लूप ऑफ Henle दिस पार्ट इज नोन एज इंटरस्टीशियल एरिया और इंटरस्टीशियल फ्लूइड इज प्रेजेंट. दिस इज द मेडुलर रीजन, एंड दिस वन इज द कॉर्टेक्स रीजन. This is medullary interstitial part or interstitial fluid. In the medullary interstitial fluid, due to the presence of ions, due to the presence of solutes, the osmolarity will increase. As we talk about the osmolarity, this amount of the solutes, the osmolarity remains 300 around in the cortex region. As we move deep inside to the medullary region, here osmolarity will reach up to 200 due to the presence of these solutes. So here in the interstitial fluids, it has many solutes, that is sodium and chloride. Generally they are present here. Now let's see what happens in this mechanism. Is mechanism mein ho kaha kya raha hai? Aap vasa recti se bhi start kar sakte hain, aap loop of Henle se bhi start kar sakte hain. So we were starting with the loop of Henle. Loop of Henle has two limbs and we know both of these two limbs has the different permeability. This loop of that is the descending limb is permeable to water only and impermeable to salts. Whereas this ascending limb is permeable to salts, but it is impermeable to water. तो इस केस में यहाँ से वाटर तो बाहर नहीं आ सकता. यहाँ से बाहर क्या आएगा? It will release the ions. When filtrate will move, it release the ions in the interstitial area. तो यहाँ से जो ions हैं ये बाहर आते हैं. Sodium chloride ion, it will come out from this interstitial space. It will come into the interstitial space from the ascending limb in the journal. अभी पूरा मैकेनिज्म देख लेंगे तो आपको आसानी से समझ में आएगा. हमने यहाँ से स्टार्ट किया है. यू कैन स्टार्ट विद हेयर ऑल्सो. सो सपोज इन व्हेन द फिल्ट्रेट इज मूविंग इन द असेंडिंग लिंब, इट्स रिलीजिंग द सोडियम क्लोराइड आयन इनटू द इंटरस्टीशियल फ्लूइड. सो एज द दिस रिलीज इनटू द आयंस इनटू द इंटरस्टीशियल फ्लूइड, हेयर द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ दीस आयंस विल इंक्रीज. द इंक्रीज कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ आयंस विल बिकम एंड दिस कंसंट्रेशन ग्रेडियंट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू रिलीजिंग द वाटर from the filtrate. The filtrate which is moving here into the loop of Henle. This filtrate which is moving into the loop of Henle. Now what will happen? As the concentration of ion will increase into the medullary region, the water will come to adjust the concentration. Pani bahar aayega because outside environment kaisa ho gaya? This will become the hypertonic. And to maintain this concentration gradient, the water will comes out from these filtrate. इस filtrate से जो है water बाहर आएगा. The water will start coming out and this region is permeable to water. So from this ascending descending limb, the water will keep coming out from this loop of Henle, this descending limb of Henle. So in this way we can see the water is coming out to maintain the osmolarity, to maintain the concentration gradient. But this is not same way. अगर इस तरीके से continuously आता रहेगा, continuously ion की concentration increase हो जाए, that it will also not possible. To maintain the concentration gradient, now what will happen? This ion, this sodium and chloride ion, which are released by the loop of Henle, they were taken by the vasa recti. अब इन्हें कौन ले लेगा? This sodium and chloride ion जो यहाँ पे release हुए थे interstitial fluid में, medullary interstitium के अंदर, they were taken by the vasa recti. Vasa recti will take that. So as this sodium and chloride taken by this descending limb of vasa recti, they will move with vasa recti and then they reach here into the ascending limb. Here in the ascending limb, this vasa recti will release back the sodium and chloride ions. As they will release back here, due to this concentration, high concentration of ions, again the water will come out. So in this way, this mechanism will remain working. Will keep working. ये वो sodium and chloride यहाँ से ascending limb बाहर छोड़ रहा है, vasa recti उसे ले रही है. vasa recti यहाँ लगे फिर से छोड़ रही है और water जो है बाहर आ रहा है. In this way the water will keep coming out till the concentration gradient is maintained to make the urine hypertonic. इस तरीके से hypertonic urine बनता रहेगा इन solutes की movement की वजह से. यहाँ पे वो कुछ नहीं रहा, just concentration maintain करने के लिए ions को intake किया जा रहा है और रिलीज किया जा रहा है. बिसाइड्स दिस सोडियम क्लोराइड, यूरिया विल ऑल्सो प्ले इंपॉर्टेंट रोल. यहाँ पे यूरिया भी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल प्ले करेगा. अगर हम स्लोपो फैमिली को आगे बढ़ाएं, इट विल कनेक्ट विद द कलेक्टिंग डक्ट, इट विल जॉइन विद द कनेक्टिंग डक्ट. यहाँ पे कलेक्टिंग डक्ट होगी. टू मेंटेन दिस ऑस्मोलैरिटी और दिस कंसेंट्रेशन ग्रेडियंट ऑफ द आयंस, द कलेक्टिंग डक्ट विल ऑल्सो रिलीज द यूरिया. The urea will also diffuse out from the collecting duct and it comes into the interstitial space. It will come here into the interstitial space. And this urea will also taken by the lupofamily. The lupofamily will also take this urea to maintain the concentration gradient. So in this way, the sodium chloride and urea, both of these two solutes, they are taking part to maintain the concentration gradient. As the urea will come here, ions are there, sodium chloride ion are there, urea are there. The concentration of ions will become here. The solute in the environment in this interstitial fluid become more and more hypertonic. Jitna jyada hypertonic hota jayega, what will come out from the filtrate, and filtrate will become the concentrated filtrate for the hypertonic urine will be formed in this way. So this is the mechanism which works here. As we know that urea is a low threshold substance, this is the reason why it is a low threshold substance, because it is required here to maintain the osmolarity. यहाँ पे osmolarity 200 तक maintain करने के लिए urea की भी जरूरत पड़ रही है. That's why the urea is required here. As the lupofamily go more deep into the medullary region, the more osmolarity will be increased. जितना ज़्यादा नीचे जाते रहेंगे, उतना ही ज़्यादा osmolarity भी increase होती जाएगी due to the much more concentration of these solutes. So in short, what is happening here? The concentration of ions is maintained inside the medullary interstitial medullary region. यहाँ पे ions की concentration maintain रखी जा रही है by taking and releasing of these ions, sodium chloride and urea. Because of this concentration, the water will release out here. The concentration will become hypertonic, then water will come out. Water जो है वो बाहर आएगा through the filtrate. As the filtrate has much more amount of water when it's filtered from the Bowman's capsule. So this water will keep coming out. Two important solutes which are taking part to maintain the concentrated urine is urea and sodium chloride. And this process is working with the help of two parts of the nephron. The one is the lupofamily and second one is known as vasorrecti. Both of these two are taking part in this process, and the concentration gradient is increased in the medullary region as we go deep inside the medullary region. Here in the cortex region is a 300, but as we go deep into the medullary region, it gets increased. Okay, so this is about the counter current mechanism.